What is up, everybody, and welcome back to Lesser Athletes. My name is Chow, and today, like always, another interesting video for you here on the channel. Today, we're going to be talking about Zach LaVine trade ideas, which is crazy to talk about because of Zach LaVine. I called it. I made a video a while ago about the takeaways. I think the Bulls are going to blow up by the deadline, and a lot of these trades are deadline trades, and I think that's what's going to happen. Bulls are going to blow it up. They're going to realize, hey, the stuff's not working. It's either going to be DeMar, which... might make a DeMar trade video. We'll see. But today we're doing Zach LaVine because that's the first person they talked to about trades. Blow it up, restart the franchise, and think about different options to go about it. Worked with a lot of teams. We're going to probably work if the Bulls do it here soon. But yeah, today we're going to be talking about some potential trade players, some trade teams, some ideas, whatever it might be. We'll get and talk about it. Make sure to like and subscribe on the video. 90% of you guys are not subscribed. We're hoping that maybe 20-30% by the end of the year. If not, that's okay. But it means a lot to us on the channel to see some subscriptions. Other than that, let's begin. Most likely, and these are obvious teams that have been already in the discussion about it. Number one, the Los Angeles Lakers, and number two, the Philadelphia 76ers. Lakers, of course, have always been the we need a third star addition ever. Lakers obviously will be in this. 76ers are going to be here because of the trade capital. They're looking like they could add another star. If they do, that they will be a dominant team. I would like to see it happen. So we'll talk about that coming up. First, we'll be talking about the Lakers. This obviously says failed because of the recently signed ideas with Rui, with Austin Reaves, with Gabe Vincent. Those are players that have already signed recently that... can't be traded till I think December 30th around there or January 15th. It's either or. And so after that, they will be, which is past that time, will be the trade deadline. So those are obviously players that are going to be interesting to talk about. Didn't include D'Lo in here because I think D'Lo would be somebody that they would want to keep with how he's been playing. Austin Reaves is another player I think they could be playing. But if you're going for Zach LaVine, who is just like an Austin Reaves, for example, in a shooting guard position, I think Zach LaVine would have to be Austin Reaves would have to be in a Zach LaVine trade. Bulls could honestly use Austin Reaves, could use him to, you know, he's been well. He almost got triple double the other day. He's been really getting his assist numbers high. He's been scoring. But again, he's kind of like, he's not the best player there. I'm not going to lie. He's not going to be someone that's going to be amazing. He's not going to be somebody that's going to be 100% superstar, but he is a star in my opinion right now. And I think that the Bulls could obviously use him. Two first round picks next year, which would obviously, let me say this, Zach LaVine is on a 4-year deal. So some of these trades are going to look a little bit crazy, but again, 4-year deals. We're talking about a 4-year deal player. On 40 mil, which is kind of crazy, but Zach LaVine I think is definitely worth it. So there's going to be some interesting trades here. Gabe Vincent, somebody that they recently signed, I think they're going to be okay with trading him for Zach LaVine. Rui Hachimura might be a little harder, the athletic player that has done very well. Interesting to see if they would do that. Two first round picks. I think LeBron is 2 or 3 years away from retiring, not maybe next year, since last year. And if so, then you have him for the 2025 season, then 2026, no LeBron, but AD is going to be there. Zach LaVine would still be there. I think it's worth it for Zach LaVine to still be there, and you trade away that pick. I think no matter what, it's going to make your team look good. And when you're trading away, you're going to have some good players still around for the Lakers. Up next is the Philadelphia 76ers. This is one that's very interesting because these three players are all on one-year contracts, expiring offers, which I think that the Bulls would actually like more than the trade showed before, with three first round picks and one that's top three protected in 2028, 2029 first round pick from the Clippers, which should be amazing with how the Clippers team is set up right now. 76ers should really use this for the Bulls. I think they would really like that. 2026 first round pick for that's either going to be OKC, Houston, or the Clippers. OKC will get the top two of those picks. The last one would go to the 76ers. And Zach LaVine to the 76ers would really like it. Three expiring contracts I think the Bulls would really like. All of them leave the next year. Now you're back with no, with all this extra cap room that you could spend on how you want to structure the team. With three first round picks, I think that's worth it for the Bulls. This is the trade I think the Bulls would really like the most, with how they talked about expiring contracts they would like with picks. This is it. But if they want to go young player, have another trade that I think would be really good. But less likely but possible. Miami Heat, a team that's always going to be in contention, and the New York Knicks. Another team that I was going to add was the Nets, but the Nets have officially said they're unlikely to go for the trade. Want to take them out. Looks like it's not going to happen. Next for the Miami Heat, Kyle Lowry, Caleb Martin, Jovic, and a 2029 first round pick for Zach LaVine. 2029 pick could look good in a year of 2023, 2024. We don't really know what's going to happen in the next 5 years. So I think a 5 year down the line Heat could look bad, could look really good, depending on how you see it. If how the team's structured, I would rather say not as good as what you would hope. But we never know. It's 5 years down the line. Zach LaVine partying with the Miami Heat would have a lineup of Tyler Hero, Zach LaVine, Jimmy Butler, or you could put Jimmy Butler at the four, put somebody else at small forward. Would it be Caleb Martin? And then bam, I think that's a really good lineup. I really like it for the Heat. For the Bulls, Kyle Lowry, expiring contract. Caleb Martin and Nikola Jovic could be players you could use that could actually be kind of useful. Jovic would be a good young player to have. Caleb Martin would be a nice player to have as well that I think you could develop into something. Both of those players would, I think, help for the long-term benefit. And then a 2029 first-round pick would be good. Not the strongest trade, but I think this is something that the Bulls could consider. Up next is the trade that I actually like the most when it comes to single young player, and it's RJ Barrett, who's actually starting to become productive. 20 points per game this season, having a very good season. Has had an injury recently that has kept him out. Evan Fournier has been wanting to get off the team for a while. Could look really bad for maybe trade value for him, but I think this is somebody that they would be able to cut, and they would be fine with cutting. 2024 first from Dallas looks like it will convey. That is projected top 10 that will convey to the Knicks. So this could be a good pickup for the Bulls for an extra first round pick immediately. 2029 first round pick from the Knicks. We don't know what's going to happen in 5 years. What can happen to the team? But for the Knicks, you're having Jalen Brunson, Zach LaVine, small forward position. RJ Barrett would be gone. I'm trying to remember. Oh, Quentin Grimes has been their starting shooting guard recently. You could put that at the four, at the small forward position. Julius Randle, Mitchell Robinson, and then you all still have Dante DiVincenzo. You still have Josh Hart. Those are great players that I think the Knicks would obviously have. Isaiah Hartenstein, Emmanuel Quickley, players that they would like to have, and I think would help them and their chances of becoming a dominant team and getting wins throughout the postseason. Dark horses for me, and I'm going to add this one afterwards. Orlando Magic. I want to see what would Orlando Magic give up. I think they have the assets too, and I'll talk about that later. And the Pelicans, both teams that I don't think will go for the trade, but I want to include them because I think they should do something and should go for the trade. Another team I was going to add, but it's just not going to work out, is the Kings. Kings tried to trade for Bradley Beal. Was kind of interested to what they were trying to offer for Bradley Beal. Was it Malik Monk, for example, which would be interesting with how his relationship is with De'Aaron Fox. Was it Kevin Herter, who I think works very well with the Kings' offense and spacing and this floor? Don't think it should be that. Wonder what it could be for the Kings, which I think a Zach LaVine would be way better, but I'm not going to try and trade for that for the Kings. I think these two teams are as good enough as for dark horses. For the Orlando Magic, they have a lot of youth and a lot of players that could work well, but if they're trying to go with not as much youth, Jonathan Isaac is somebody that in 2 years would be an expiring contract. Defensive player that I think is good. They played him in the last minutes for the Bulls game that Paolo Banchero did have a game winner. Gary Harris, $13 million a year, 1 year contract would be very nice that they could use to expiring contract again. Jalen Suggs is somebody that I think would work well as a point guard position, shooting guard position for them. Very good defensively. Hasn't been this player that we would hope though from the Orlando Magic. Two first round picks, 2024 first round picks, 2026 first round pick. Probably wouldn't be the best, but still good first round picks with some good young players. Zach LaVine on the Magic. You would have a incredible lineup of you could either put Markelle Fultz at the point guard, Anthony Black either at the point guard, Zach LaVine, small forward with Franz, power forward with Paolo, with center Wendell Carter. That's an amazing lineup. I think that's a lineup that could make it to the playoffs. If the Orlando Magic are wanting to excel their timeline and wanting to make it to the playoffs, the Magic is the trade for me that I think makes the most sense. I think it's going to depend on, are they willing to excel their timeline? Because I think they do have time and they can wait a little bit more. If they're not, the trade makes no sense for them. If they are, then this trade is perfect for them. They could offer maybe a little bit more. Bulls and Magic have dealt in the past for Vucevic and Wendell Carter originally. I really, and actually that pick turned into Franz Wagner and Jet Howard that they traded for Vucevic. Want to see what the Magic do because I think, you know, James Harden worked well with the team. Zach LaVine will work well with the team, and we'll have to see what happens. Up next is the New Orleans Pelicans. Oh, actually, let me talk about that Orlando Magic quick. Zach LaVine obviously wants to be on a team that's winning or higher. There could be some teams that would make sense, like the Pistons, to have a Zach LaVine. Why would Zach LaVine want to go on a worse team on the Bulls to go to the Pistons? Doesn't make sense in my opinion. That's why the Magic would have to excel their timeline a little bit. Other teams are winning now. For example, the Pelicans. This trade doesn't make sense unless CJ McCollum's kind of in it, and it kind of sucks to have CJ McCollum kind of in it. But I think with the Pelicans, with CJ McCollum being injured for a little bit, and you've already done super well with Jordan Hawkins standing, taking a stance and doing better. Dyson Daniels standing up. Players' injuries that are really affecting the Pelicans, players are standing and doing better and stepping up to the you know, better spotlight. I think the Pelicans would be fine with trying to get a Zach LaVine where you have Dyson Daniels, maybe Zach LaVine, Ingram, Zion, and Vucevic. And then on the bench, you still have Trey Murphy. You still have Jose Alvarado, Jordan Hawkins, like I just talked about. Some other important players, Larry Nance. There's some important players where I think the Pelicans should go for this offer. It makes sense for the Bulls. Doesn't really make sense for you to go for a CJ McCollum with 3 years deal. This could definitely be a piece you could trade for more assets. Think about how Jrue Holiday, maybe not as big as Jrue Holiday's what he got, but definitely a first round pick or two, maybe something like that. The contract's gonna hurt, so maybe it's actually less. We'll have to see. Kyrie Lewis just has not played as well as you would hope for the Pelicans. Doesn't really have the minutes. The Bulls are players that I think they would want to play and specialize a little bit. 2024 first round pick from the Lakers is definitely interesting. 2025 first round pick from the Pelicans would not be as well. 2027 maybe. Zion looks iffy this season still. I think he's still a dominant player, but is he really the player that we're gonna hope? I think it's too early to tell. 2025 first, not gonna be as good. But Lakers 2024 first. Reason why I said interesting. Right now they're the 8th seed. Again, this is early season, so of course it means nothing. But we're gonna have to see what happens with a West that's so competitive. I think that the Lakers could win and go to the finals. But we're just gonna have to see what happens. Other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed the season. I said season. Other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Other than that, let me know what you guys think down in the comments below. Other than that, I hope you guys enjoy, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.